They put him on a helicopter. Nicolás has left us.
Gringo must think the Americans are here.
God help us if they are.
That's sick. I'm a soldier, not a sadist.
Come on, you know you want to watch.
I don't. Broadcasting murder is barbaric.
You're naive to think it's anything but history.
It's a pointless conversation. We're on patrol at the moment.
I don't want to die in this cesspit.
Thank God. They were gonna kill us.
You've come to save us. Where are the others?
It's just me.
Oh, crap.
You are American.
You're Chinese.
The PRC ambassador to Myanmar. I must speak with a representative of your government.
They hear everything I do. Shoot.
Kong Furong does not represent the will of China. He is a splinter faction of the Chinese army. All of them fanatics and fools.
What does he want?
First, Taiwan, with others to follow. Gifts to the PRC he thinks they will not be able to refuse.
How is Nicolas involved?
Trade. Furong provides transport and munitions in exchange for weapons-grade nuclear waste.
Does China know?
No. And unless they are issued proof of Furong's activities, I fear the certainty of war.
What's the proof?
On the computer in his office. My office. He has overridden and reset the lock.
I force him to open his computer and forward the contents to the PRC. And our countries don't go to war.
Such is my hope.
The Americans are picking the basement. I want all available men on the basement. We'll kill them all. Colonel Bagrat, report! Colonel Bagrat! Damnation! I'm going down there. Lofenko, you're coming with me.
Kill Renko. His men are mercenaries. Their only cause is money.
So, once Renko's dead, they stop.
Help! Jesus, they're about to shoot!
Echelon just picked out an intercept. Furong knows that Grinko's dead and Nicolas is gone.
That's not good.
Get back to the embassy. He's trying to destroy the evidence that could keep us out of a war.
Right.